is associate professor of music and the head of the piano area at the University of Central Oklahoma. She has spent that last semester here during her sabbatical practicing on our instruments nearly every day. She is a diligent musician who spends many, many, many hours, puts a lot of the rest of us to shame, I might say, perfecting her craft. She is an amazing pianist. If you've heard Sally play, you know that. But she is now branching out and is taking on the pipe organ. You are, as I said, in for a great treat. So would you please join me in welcoming Dr. Sally Pollock.
I just want to say a couple of things before I continue. It is so nice to share this evening with all of you. Thank you so much for being here in person and online. I have people watching at home. I think these are the right cameras to look at. Thank you so much for being here. A huge shout out to the most wonderful Bainbridge Allen for doing all the video, and also Jack Stewart for doing all the video and audio tonight and the live stream. I also want to thank the Reverend Dr. Todd Prickett for allowing me this time to nest amongst your music ministry and be a part of UCC this semester. UCC is my home. It's where I grew up, and I am forever grateful to the staff, ministers, and especially Todd for your support and friendship. I also want to thank the University of Central Oklahoma for taking a chance and investing in continued education and for the well-being of their faculty. I want to thank my home church, Westminster Presbyterian Church in Oklahoma City, for also allowing me this time away. Thank you to the Fort Worth AGO and to Peggy Graff for providing such opportunities and support for students like myself. And finally, I want to dedicate this recital to my wonderful parents, Janet and Doug Pummel. What a blessing it has been to spend this time with you this past semester. I titled this first set, Foundations and Inspiration. The study of Bach is foundational for all instruments. The chorale that you just heard is based on the famous Pentecostal Lutheran hymn, hence the red shoes. The hymn is entitled Veni Creator Spiritus, or Come Holy Spirit, and it's highly appropriate for music in this very holy place. Buxtehude had 7 daughters, and when he was not trying to marry them off to other famous composers, he was actually writing really great music. I think you will enjoy the interplay between improvisation and complex composition in this next great C major masterpiece. And this piece is actually very inspirational for me. My mom played it a couple of years ago for a church service that I was attending, and I just was floored. I loved this piece so much. And it was at that moment that I decided that I really wanted to learn how to play the organ. So here we are. Thank you, thank you. The next group I've entitled Scream, Laugh, Pray, because French music tends to musically crystallize human emotions and frame them into sound. Saint-Saëns was an unmistakable virtuoso. He lived a very long life and wrote masterpieces in all genres. He actually was an organist by trade. The organists in the room and online will understand why I may want to scream, because obviously Saint-Saëns was able to do the same thing with his feet that he was able to do with his hands. And it's really hard, so bear with me. 2 centuries earlier, François Couperin was also an organist by trade, but surprisingly, a lot of his music, his organ music, did not survive. We are left with just a couple of volumes of his organ work, and this little fun piece comes from one of his 2 surviving organ masses. He is known for his descriptive, evocative, and sometimes whimsical keyboard music. And I might have a little fun with this one. The Prelude Modal sounds like a prayer to me. It is colorful and modern, yet understandable. Zhang Longley lived and created in the 20th century. Longley's life was extraordinary. He was blind by age 2. He wrote some incredible organ music while being the main organist at one of the most famous churches in France. And someday, I would like to go to Paris and hear the organs that these great composers occupied. Maybe we should plan a trip.
Thank you.
For this last group, I'm choosing American composers. Amy Beach was a composer who worked at the turn of the 20th century. She was extremely famous during her lifetime, and she still should be today. She was the first female composer to have a symphony premiered by the great American orchestras at the turn of the century in the late 1800s. She was a pioneer in education as well as in voting rights for women, and she was also a virtuoso pianist. I will actually call her the Clara Schumann of the U.S. My amazing colleague at Westminster Presbyterian Church, Dr. Melissa Plowman, played an organ piece of hers for church, and I just loved it so much. So Melissa is the inspiration behind this choice. Those of you in the audience with Irish roots will recognize the famous Irish tune. Beverly Hills-based composer Craig Phillips is quite famous in the organ composition world, and he wrote this great setting of the tune, hymn tune Engelberg, which you will recognize in the transcendent middle section. And finally, the last few months, I've allowed myself a lot of personal grace, and I appreciate all the grace that my family and my colleagues have given me this semester. So we will end with Amazing Grace. This setting is by J. Christopher Pardini, who is an organist who used to be the organist at the famous Crystal Cathedral and is now based in Pennsylvania. I'm going to actually ask my special assistant to help me on the last piece. My assistant is my amazing, graceful mother. She has been an inspiration to me for my entire life, and she is an inspiration on this organ at this church. Most of the registrations that you have heard on these works are a product of my own experimentation, trial and error. I'm kind of like a kid in a candy store on this great Dan Garland organ. I feel a little bit like a DJ, actually. But this last Amazing Grace is entirely my mom's registration, and I wanted her to be the one to do the honors to help pull the stops on it since they are hers. And I want to dedicate this last set to you, Mom. And also after the concert, for you all in attendance, we have a reception at my parents' house. So if you're not sure where that is, please ask my mom or my dad or myself for the address, and we would love for you all to come. Thank you.